And it is a dance, because it's not like walking. You just gotta kind of float through there. Like, oh, I remember you. Caterpillars and butterflies and fairies and loved ones you might have lost. Those who are to come that aren't yet born. It gets really deep in the astral plane. You gotta be ready to go there. But one thing that they have there is a whole lot of light. And it's in so many different shades, more shades than we're able to see with our eyes. So what we see is blue and red and green, and they see like colors all between and multi, like we can't even fathom. So when you do go visit, you see all these lights. But none of that's really important. The only thing that's important is that when you go there, you go with your own light. So you walk in to the astral plane, bearing something that no other spirit, soul, or being could ever bear. It's your own light. And you carry it here on Earth too, and that's what makes Earthlings so magical, is because they can exist in more realms than one. Beings that on the astral plane are waiting to get here, or I've already gone. But they can't exist on both, so it's cool when you're in a body and you can visit there and you can come back. All of that to say, you got a light inside of you. And I know you're gonna leave and you'll be like, she's crazy. But that's all right. Long as you remember this, that you have a light and you must shine, because Earth right now needs all beings to shine their own individual light in the fullest capacity and the greatest potential they can. And you need to understand that consciousness flickers, so you can't shine as bright every single moment. So don't put pressure on yourself. You are a human, but you can lean on your friends and you can lean on your family. And when you feel weak, you just let them shine for you. And that's all I got to say. Is there a light that you have inside you can't touch? A looking glass can only show you so much. Just trust.